joining me today. My name is Vera. I'm a health and wellness instructor from Stonebridge Community Services, and that means my job is to help keep you healthy, active, and motivated at every age. Today, we're here at the Fort Stanley Fitness Center, and we're showing our appreciation to frontline workers and PSWs. We know you've been working hard during the last few months. All that lifting and transferring can be hard on your shoulders. So today's program targets shoulder care. Even if you're not a frontline worker, I hope you join us. And today, all you need is 2 water bottles, 4 lightweights, something under 3 pounds, and a pillow. You can use a pillow to start with if it feels bad under your head, but we'll definitely use it when we're on the belly. So we're going to start by lying down on our backs. And the first thing we're going to do is let our arms come all the way up to the ceiling. Imagine somebody's got a hold of your wrist and they're pulling you up, 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 up. And then relax so the tips of your shoulders are nice and flat on the mat. And then from here, try to keep the rib cage nice and heavy as you let the arms come overhead. And when you get here, just reach up a little higher with one hand and then the other. So nice long reach. Back and forth like there's something just out of reach. See if you can get it. And then when you're ready, we're going to let our hands come all the way down to the sides. And then walk your hands down towards your feet. Walk the feet up towards your hands. Shoulders are nice and wide. We're going to start with some bridging. So squeeze the glutes and a little energy in the toes. And let the hips come up. And from here, hold it there. Make sure you're breathing. I always like it if you count out loud, then I know you're breathing. Let's go 4, 3, 2, and up. One more time, big breath in to prepare. Squeeze, lift, and hold. 4, 3, 2, and down. Perfect. From here, we're going to let one knee come up towards your chest, and then the other. And then when we're ready, glue your feet together. Make sure your knees are in far enough so you feel like your ribs are nice and flat on the floor. We want to brace the abs, so feel like if you poked yourself, there would be some resistance. So nice, tight abs. And then while you're here, we're going to push the feet together and just open the knees and close. And open. I promise you shoulder care, it's coming, but we're going to see some core in there as well. And close. And open, press the feet, just waking those hips up. Let's go 4 more. 3 more. 2 more. And very last, 1. Perfect. Okay, if it's okay for your shoulders to bring your hands behind your back, that's going to give you a little more feedback on how strong your core is feeling. And from here, just try to press your back into your hands. We're going to point the toes and just let your feet come down to wherever you can go without feeling a change in your back. And it's not about touching the floor, it's about finding that point where you can really press against your hands and come up again. And exhale. And inhale, squeeze the knees together, up we go. And 3. And just 2 more. And up, squeeze the knees, last 1. And up, you should feel a little core there. From here, we're going to do some bicycling. So just extend one leg out. Imagine you're on a bicycle. You can't reach the pedal. Nice long legs coming down again, keeping that back flat, and switch it. So just pedaling that bike. The focus is to really keep that back pressed into your hands. Let's go 4. Keep breathing. 3. And 2. Well done. 1 more. Perfect. Bring the knees in. Give it a little shake. And now when you're ready, we're going to bring our hands behind our head. And now let's press your elbows into the mat, really opening up the chest and shoulder. And relax. And press. And relax. 2 more. Big press. And now this time while you're pressing, just gently look down at your knees, press your head into your hands,
And one more time, elbows and head, and relax. The next exercise is called the tail wag. So we're gonna bring the feet over to touch our hands. So imagine there's $100 bill between your knees. Keep those knees glued together. Knees are in far enough so your back's nice and flat. And we're just gonna bring the foot over to touch the hand. And let's go five more, four more, three more, feel those obliques, two more, and very last one. Perfect, same thing on the other side. Just gonna tap the feet to the hands, five, and four, and three, and two. Very last one, well done. Let's lower one foot down and then the other. And then when you're ready, roll over so that you're facing me. So from here, we're gonna lift that top leg up. Imagine you can balance a book on it so it's nice and flat. And then press that foot down like you're trying to push against the wall that's down there. And as you push the foot down, you should feel a little lift through your waist. That's what we want. We want that nice, strong core. Imagine somebody's gonna give you a push. Everything's engaged, they can't push you over. And then from here, we're gonna lift that top leg up. Six, and five. So it's a long lift, like we're trying to reach that wall and not a high lift, because you wanna keep your spine nice and straight, that area between your ribs and your hips, nice and long. Three more, and two more, and very last one. Good job. From here, let's tap our toes together and lift and just tap your toes. And two. So now we're going to get more into the back side of the leg, hamstrings, glutes. Four. And three. And two. And one. Perfect. And now let's bring the heels together. And we're just going to tap our heels together. Five. Relax the neck, four, and three, and two, and very last one. Perfect. If you need to give that leg a little shake, give it a little hug, give it a little chance to relax. And then when you're ready, we're going to bring that leg behind the other leg. And now again, pretend you're balancing a book on that foot, knees facing forward, lift them from the inside seam of your pants, just coming up. And relax that neck, two, and three, and down, four more, three more, two more, very last one. Well done, come on down. From here, let's stack our knees up, bring both knees in, and we're gonna grab that water bottle. So now just bring your elbow right to the side seam of your shirt, press in with that elbow, try to crush your rib cage, and then we're just gonna pretend that elbow's a hinge and open the door. And close. Two. So small weights are needed to really wake up that rotator cuff. If we were to use heavier weights, your prime movers would kick in and we wouldn't get that joint stabilization. If you want to make that a little more challenging, if that doesn't hurt, just come on up, turn your thumbs to the back wall like you're hitch making, and in and out. And up, turn the thumb back to the center, and down. And three. Remember that core nice and strong. And four. Let's get four more. Three more. It's one of the most important exercises for that shoulder stability. Two more. And very last one. Perfect. When we get up here, turn your knuckles so they're facing me. Nice light grip on the water bottle. We don't want to be squeezing really tight. Let your shoulders just settle into the joint. And now just look at the creases of your elbows. And we're going to turn the creases of the elbow towards the back wall. And so really just loosening that shoulder in the joint. Two. And release. And three. And back. Three. towards the knees, almost touching the top of the knees. Just scoop up and come up towards your ear. So again, down towards the knees, almost touching the front of the knees, that little scoop, and up we go. Relax the neck. Three. Facing the ceiling, we're going to bring our arm about shoulder height, and now just lower it down to the floor and up to that shoulder height again. And two, and three. Core still engaged. Imagine somebody's going to give you that big push. Core is nice and tight. If somebody were to come up and give you a little poke, you'd be nice and strong. Three more. Two more, and very last one. Perfect. Okay, the water bottle can come down. From here, we're going to roll over to our stomach. This is where we really need that pillow. We want to give ourselves a little bit of a double chin. If you wanted to use your water bottle for this exercise, you could, but I'm going to start with it because it's usually we're a little weak the back side, and it's really important for our posture. So that double chin, we're going to take the arms out to the side and see how wide you can reach your hands away from each other. A little bit of a double chin, and then we're going to lift the arms and lower. And two, and three. If you want to make that a little stronger, a little more intense, turn the thumbs up to the ceiling. Go four and five and six, two more, seven, one more, and eight. Perfect. And here we're going to turn the knuckles back up to the ceiling. Imagine you're balancing books on the back of your hands as you make snow angels. Coming down to the side of your leg and up to wherever your shoulders let you go. And down. Two more, and up, and on the very last arm, we're going to bring our hands right down to the side. We're slapping the floor, so our palms are flat on the floor. Slide your hands down towards your feet, a little bit of a double chin, and as we unweight our head from the pillow, looking down at the mat, we're going to also lift the hands. So let everything come up and then turn the thumbs up towards the ceiling and push your fingers down towards your feet. Hold it there for four and three and two and again, a little bit of a double chin. Unweight the forehead. The hands come up. The thumbs turn towards the ceiling. Push, push, push the fingers down towards your toes. Four and three. And two, and two to go. Big breath in. As we come up, that little double chin. Press, press, press. And release. Very last one. Up we go. Hold it there for four, and three, and two, and down. Perfect. And here, let's come right up onto our elbows. And then when you're ready, we're going to pull your belly button away from the mat, engage your core. And with that left foot, we're going to just squeeze an invisible tennis ball behind the knees just to open up the hips. And as you're there holding that invisible tennis ball, just press that hip a little heavier into the mat and lengthen that knee away from your shoulder. Just opening up through the front of the hip. In a minute, we're going to be lifting that leg. If those hip flexors and quads are a little more relaxed, it'll be a little easier. And relax. Good job. And now, same thing on the other side. Just going to squeeze that invisible tennis ball and then push the hips down into the mat and lengthen that knee away from your shoulder. Nice deep breaths as you just let that front of the hip relax. strong here. Again, imagine somebody's going to give you a big push. Core is engaged, we're nice and strong. And now, without bending the elbow, retract that shoulder blade. And down. And two. I'm just going to turn so you can see me. And three. And release. And four. And release. Four more. Three more. Don't hold too tight on that water bottle. It'll raise your blood pressure. So nice light grip. Last one. Okay, we're adding on to it. So the shoulder blade retracts. The arm comes out into airplane position. The arm comes down and release. And two, open, down, and release. And three, open, down, and release. Three more, open, down, and release. Two more, open, down, and release. And very last one, open, down, and release. And now those arms have done a lot of work, so we're going to do a big stretch. So come on down to the bottom of the mat, water bottles out in front, knees are a little bit wide. We're going to roll the water bottle away from your body. If it hurts to go overhead, come out a little bit more to the side. If it hurts to stay on that arm, come on down to the elbow. So if your wrists are getting tired, come on down. We're going to roll that arm away from your body. You feel a nice stretch through your lats. And when you get as far away from your tailbone as you can, pull your tailbone back towards your heels and make that stretch even stronger. Nice deep breathing. And with every exhale, roll that water bottle maybe a little bit more away from the tailbone and pull the tailbone back away from the water bottle. Two more deep breaths. Perfect. Switch sides. So again, just rolling that water bottle away. If you want to come down, feel free. Pull that tailbone back towards your heels and roll that water bottle away from your tailbone. Just push and pull, create that length and opposition through your spine. Those nice tight muscles in your lats, you're going to loosen them up, give your arms a little extra room to move. And relax. Perfect. Okay, when you're ready, we're going to take our head over to the other side of the mat. If it bothers you to have your arm here under your head, if you have any pain, make sure you have a pillow. Don't leave your head hanging there. It's really important to support that head. Top leg comes up, balance that invisible book on it, knees facing forward, and then press against that wall. You should feel that whole lift up in your lower body. And then when you're ready, we're just going to lift and lower that leg. And two, and three, and four, two more, five, last one, and now toes together. Touch your toes as you come down. One, and two, and three. Four, poke test, make sure your abs are awake. Five, and six, and now rotating from the hip, knees are facing up, click the heels. One, and two, and three, and four, two more, five, and six. Well done. Big hug for that leg, it's been working hard. And then when you're ready, we're going to lower that leg behind. Think of those muscles on the inside of the leg, lifting that leg and lower. And two, and in, and three, and in. Three more. Two more. And very last one. Well done, relax. And then when we're ready, both knees come in. Hold on to that water bottle. Elbows glued to the rib cage as we open the door. And close. And two. And remember, if you want to add that little hitchhiking movement with the thumb back, turn in and down. And four. And five. Five more. Four more. Three more. Two more. And very last one. Perfect. Just looking at the creases of the elbow and turning all the way back to the back wall, and so trying to rotate from the shoulder. Because I could turn the hand with very little shoulder movement, but we want to really rotate that shoulder in the socket. Three more. Two more. And last one. Perfect. And now thumbs down towards the knees, a little digging of the hole coming up. And in. And two. And three. And three more. And two more. Last one. Good job. The bottle can come down. And then when you're ready, we're going to come all the way up to seated. And you can sit however you're comfortable, cross-legged in a chair, whatever feels right for you. Roll the shoulders back. You want to make sure that we're showing off the necklace or tie. The sternum's in front of the shoulders. And we're going to let the arms come up and down. And two. And down. Right. Core still nice and tight. Nobody can push you over. Three more. And you'll find because the rotator cuff is a little tiny set of four muscles that they fatigue quickly with light weights. So don't be surprised if they get tired even though our weight's not very heavy. One more, and now I'm a little bit wider. You can still see them easily in the periphery. Coming up and down. One. And two. And three. Three more, two more, last one, hold it here, we've got three little circles, three, and two, pause and reverse, three, and two, very last one. Now we're going to just try to tuck your elbows together behind your back, squeeze, 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 and release, and squeeze. And release. Three more. And reach. Two more. And reach. Very last one. And out. Now we're going to pull down. And back. And two. And back. We're almost there. Three. Three more. Two more. Last one, perfect, and now just push the thumbs out, four out, two, and three, three more, two more, last one, well done. The bottles can go down, we're going to let one arm come all the way up, and then from here we're going to come up to wherever you can go beside your ear. And then we're going to just turn your little baby finger towards your opposite shoulder blade like you're trying to slice it off. Wherever your arm can go for that assist, down here or up here. And then just push the elbow up into your hand and maybe a little gentle push with the back of your head into your forearm. Hold it there for four and three and two and relax. The other side, shaking hands. All the way up to wherever you can go. Make sure you're working in a pain-free range of motion. Turn that little baby finger around. Come on all the way up. Push that elbow into your hands. Feel that opening between your ribs and your hips. And maybe a little gentle push with your head into your forearms, looking down at your knees. Perfect. And then those elbows towards the back wall. Let's take our gaze down from looking straight ahead to looking up towards the ceiling, and let the elbows open up as much as they can. And relax. And then just one hand behind the back, and hold on to that wrist with a little gentle pull down towards the floor. A little bit of a double chin. If you're holding your right hand, you'd be taking your ear towards your left and vice versa. Nice stretch to the neck and shoulders. Get all that tension out of your neck. And then same thing on the other side. Little gentle pull with the wrist. Keep looking down at the floor as we bring the ear over to the other shoulder. Nice deep breath. Relax. Get all the tension out of your neck. Notice what's there and breathe into it. And then back to the center. Big breath up. Reach for the sky. Thank you for being here today. Come on down. Take a bow. I really appreciate all that you do for us, and I'm glad you could join us today. I look forward to seeing you next week.